cama. And you say, yes, please. I say, oh, welcome. And you say, yes, please. You getting it colder? My toes were gonna freeze. radio friendly.
On the day we met, I threw my hat away. Oh, what a foolish thing to do. Now I'm alone and bald, you know I miss my hat. And oh, baby, I miss you. Now I'm lonely, lonely like a child without candy, lonely like a boneless dog. 'Cause you took your coat, you took your hat, you took our love and went away. You took everything to Prague. Every day you say you're doing fine, eating baklava, eating dessert every day. I know you're not thinking of me, I know you aren't flossing regularly. Why do you risk so much? Baby, why do you risk our love this way? And baby, I miss you, baby. Baby, I miss you, baby.
Baby, I miss you.
Oh, baby, I miss you. Baby, I miss you. Baby, 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 I miss you, baby.
Thank you. we can make honey, baby. Oh, we can make honey, baby. Let me tell you about that honey. Let me tell you about the honey we can make, baby. Like the world had never seen.
I hear that old whistle blowing on the train. I hear that old rooster crowing once again. You know, we've come so far, we've damn near reached the end. And I'd rather be in jail, baby, be your friend. I started the dishwasher and I donned my old Stetson cap and I stole your VCR. I hope you don't have a problem with that. And I printed out all our old emails and I threw them away. Be rather naive of you at this point to think I'm gonna stay. So get yourself another Uber. Get your bad self another fool that ain't me. Yeah, 'cause this fool ain't fooling around here no more. Yeah. And if there could be some reimbursement for the patience I have shown, and would that my heart too were made of stone, and would that all your sin against him should be cast into a lake of fire. And would that man or beast could tame this monster called Lazarus. I'm a rambling man. Yeah, I got them rambling shoes. And I got nothing to do. Yeah, and I watch the WB almost constantly, and it ain't so bad. In fact, I like it. Go get yourself another fool. Get your bad self another fool. It ain't me. This fool ain't fooling around here.
Side bottom, side bottom. I run 100 miles an hour. I use 1,000 watts of power. Oh, I got it figured out. Side bottom, side bottom. You know I smell just like a fly. Well, I don't hardly ever take no shower. sometimes I hear voices. Side bottom, side bottom. Well, I woke up here up in this town. Don't drink that milk, I think it's sour. Yes, sir, I got me 300 feet of copper wire stashed under my bedspread. Don't ask me nothing about you, 'cause I don't know. I don't know. Side bottom, side bottom. It's your average everyday side bottom. And I don't know nothing about nothing. Bottom, side, bottom. I run a million miles. I use a billion watts of power. Yes, sir. I don't know nothing.
In Montreal, the Seattle grunge had yet to make its mark. The streets, they were deserted, and the sky, it was starting to get dark. Fans counted down the hours till the madness could begin. When over the horizon the tour buses rumbled in. The sun was setting slowly like a white hot magnesium flame. Axl Rose had wanted Ice-T to be a part of the ordeal. But James Hetfield overruled him, saying that it really wasn't such a good idea. Now Axl Rose was bitter as hell, and the tension began to mount. They all presumed that he would pull through, and it counted. And his anger smoldered on like a white hot magnesium flame. The roadies were intent backstage. They wanted everything to go just right. In the rafters up above, some men were busy putting a light biggest gig they'd ever seen. In all of that, Chris, the pop music establishment would speak of it for years. The night would burn in infamy like a white hot black geese. Axl Rose was being an asshole. They all tried to stay out of his way. Lars Ulrich and Slash were chatting quietly about macrame. And Faith No More were warming up. They were opening the show. James Hetfield, he was restless, though there was no way he could know. His name was shining on the wheel of fate like a white hot magnesium plate. Well, where can the pyrotechnician be? The house manager was pacing back and forth. Should have been here half an hour ago, and I'll never find another this far north. Outside the sky was clouding over as a flock of geese flew past. The audience speculated about which band would kick more ass. The explosion set in the corner with no one to set up the white hot magnesium plate. You see, theatricality was the word for the music. It had no content. The audience paid at the nose for tickets, and they knew just what they wanted. Explosions and lots of omen, a really kicking sound, so their ears would still be ringing when the morning rolled around. Yeah, noise and adrenaline and a red hot magnesium plate. Faith No More was winding up their set when the pyrotechnician staggered in. Three hours late, he could hardly speak, and his breath was stinking of gin. Lars complained it wasn't safe for such a lush to run the flares. He was working semi-consciously, but no one seemed to care except Lars, who made a mental note to keep his distance from the white hot magnesium plate. I cannot find my hat, said Slash. It was last seen on my head, and it is black. He ran off in a tizzy just as Faith No More were coming back.
All right, we're Faith No More.
And Axl Rose was on the phone to his agent in LA. Jason Newsted smiled knowingly, but there wasn't much to say. The crescent moon shined brightly like a white hot magnesium plate. Axl Rose slammed down the phone. I'm afraid my voice just isn't in its prime. Lars approached a roadie, said, "Hey man, could you give me the time?" It was
then that Slash returned with a furrow on his brow. Rhodey said, man, it's 10:15, and I said, wrong, the time is now. Metallica jumped the stage among the
white hot magnesium blade.
Lights dimmed as the band came on. An anxious hush fell over the crowd. James Hetfield turned to Kirk Hammett saying, hey man, don't forget to play friggin' loud. The sound was indescribable. It screeched and whirled and roared. The band's routine was flawless after all the years they toured. Made all the more dramatic by the
white hot magnesium flame.
Hetfield was playing mercilessly when he was spooked by some kind of weird sound. Really wandered towards the audience and he turned suddenly around. Lost gesture to the control booth, wanting desperately to shout. He could see the pyrotechnician had gingerly passed out. James didn't know what hit him next was a
white hot magnesium flame.
The initial blast alone would easily have killed a lesser man. It is truly remarkable the magnitude of heat he could withstand. His skin was all bubbling and his hair was all on fire. Is that the best you got? James Hetfield laughed as the flames roared higher and higher. He was looking straight into the eyes of the
white hot magnesium flame.
Kirk Hammett cried, Lars Ulrich screamed. Backstage all the roadies began to weep. The house manager kicked and screamed at the pyrotechnician who lay passed out in a heap. Jason Newsted stood inscrutable, blank look in his eyes, as Slash returned having found his hat, but he dropped it in surprise. The personnel all scrambled to extinguish the
white hot magnesium flame.
Axl Rose was on the phone again, unaware of the tragedy outside. I simply won't go on tonight. It's a matter of integrity and pride. You're just insecure about your voices. Tired agent yelled. If you don't get out there and play tonight, you can surely go to hell. On stage, the people pulled James Hetfield from the
white hot magnesium flames.
Where can the paramedics be? Lars Ulrich cried, our need for them is dire. Oh, are they lost? Are they dead? Or perhaps their ambulance has blown a tire?
Well, they could have got there sooner. They'd been allowed backstage, but there hadn't been issued passes, and it was locked up like a cage. They waded through the crowd to the
White Hot Magnesium Flames.
In the celebrity wing of the hospital, James Hetfield was placed onto a bed. Nurses were anointing him from his toes all the way up to his head. And his fingernails were melted and his skin was charred and brown. It wasn't many hours later when James Hetfield came around. He'd returned from the brink of death at the
White Hot Magnesium Flames.
Please give me your attention, a voice boomed out from the speakers way up high. James Hetfield is at the hospital. Wish him luck, though it is true that he may die. And I must also mention, in another sorry note, that Axl Rose will not perform. He's having trouble with his throat. The crowd's anger rose up like a
white hot magnesium flame.
I mean this not only as your doctor, but also as a fan. You will never, 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 never play guitar again. Be careful you don't try to move, you're liable to faint. I'm glad to see you're still alive, you're looking like a saint. James Hetfield had plunged deep into the
White Hot Magnesium Flame.
Did you ever wonder why that happened to those people?
James Hetfield was unhappy now. He'd rather die than prematurely retire. It was all the worse to think it was all on account of some stupid wussy fire. His vital signs began to fade and his temperature to rise. The doctor could do nothing now and it didn't even try. James Hetfield saw a figure standing in the
White Hot Magnesium Flame.
Back at the concert, the announcer tried to apologize for the program's sudden change. Offering tickets to Wilson Phillips to anyone who desired an exchange. But the crowd arose in anger over the ticket prices they had paid, and they rioted upon the stage where Axl hadn't played. Several more were injured by the
White Hot Magnesium Flame.
I'm the devil, Mr. Hetfield. James Hetfield said, I believe we've met before. You were at the after party for that gig we played outside of Baltimore. devil tipped his hat and said, I'm glad that you recall. James Hetfield eyed the devil's hand and knew exactly what he saw. The contract there was shining like a
white hot magnesium.
It really is unfortunate the magnesium burns upon your hands. There's more than just your life at stake. You must also think of the members of your band. I'd gladly sell my soul to you, but you have it, I believe. The devil said, James, what I want's your artistic integrity.
Oh, no.
The devil's eyes twinkled like a
white hot magnesium plate.
Yes, Major, if you didn't have much artistic integrity to start with,
you're gonna have to change your sound. You're gonna have to go a little bit soft.
Master,
you're gonna have to be accessible. You're gonna have to cut all your long hair off. You're gonna have to be commercial, and although it may seem wrong, you're gonna have to make some songs that are sequels to other songs. James Hetfield's smile was bright like a
white hot magnesium flame.
The police took full 5 hours to clear all of the rioters away. The sun was rising slowly. The sky had turned from black to red to gray. The damage to the arena was awesome to behold. The house manager retired, he was really getting way too old. The roadies packed up all the stuff for the
white hot magnesium flame.
The story made the papers, some took it as a sign of social decay. Axl Rose was back on the phone, looking for a new agent in L.A. Within a week, all the debris were swept from the stadium ground. The damage had all been repaired, but Slash's hat was never found. It had been lost forever that night, Mr.
White hot magnesium flames.
The recovery was miraculous. The doctor had never been so proud. Metallica finished up the tour with a session guitarist they had found. Guns N' Roses played the tour, then faded from the charts. Seattle grunge would soon emerge to steal away our hearts. Metallica shone on like a
white hot magnesium flame.
Load came out in early 96. Lars Ulrich felt so ashamed. Reload was soon to follow. Kirk Hammett very nearly changed his name.
Jason Newsted smiled knowingly at James Hetfield and his fans. The devil's little contract had fit right in with his plans to sell out everything but the
White Hot Magnesium Flame.
To rain on your parade.
But Smash Mouth sucks! It sucks! Smash Mouth sucks! They suck!
They suck.